Ma'am, apparently the Prime Minister is on the phone for you.
Yes. Why did you look that far?
Yes, this is Her Majesty speaking. Yes, I'm going to make another video about sewing. I do not care that the last sewing videos I've made were the lowest views on my channel. It's what pleases me, not them. No, I do not care about the algorithm. Hello, and welcome back at court. In case you couldn't tell, I am now the proud owner of the cold virus that my husband had. This is why he's a consort and not a king. If you follow me on Instagram, you will have noticed that I tend to pick up historical vintage clothing and hats, of course. And a piece that I have fallen absolutely in love with. It is an original 1920s flapper dress. And I call it a flapper dress quite specifically. Not everything from the 1920s is flapper or Gatsby, but this is a true 1920s flapper dress. It has these very high slits that go up to the mid-thigh, which would be exposing to her garters if she were to be dancing. It is also very sheer. You can see straight through it. If not for a slip, nothing would be left to the imagination of this dress, which would be absolutely eye-popping and tantalizing. Perhaps it's kind of weird and a little bit gross, but one of the things I absolutely love is the fact that under the arm, you have these long sweat stains, and there's evidence of it being repaired multiple times, showing that it had a long partying life. It was a Gatsby level flapper dress.
It brings tears to my eyes.
And in a matter of nanoseconds, I had purchased 3 patterns to create a 1920s silhouette for myself. The focus of this video is on the foundation portion of any 1920s silhouette, being the combinations and the garter. Since my dearly beloved consort decided to bequeath to me his cold, I didn't do a whole lot of checking in during the sewing process. I did do a lot of filming, but excuse you. Thanks to him, I'm going to be doing a lot of overdubbing of the footage. Feel free to lob tomatoes at him in the comments.
I chose a pattern that I had found on Etsy, and I will link it down in the description below in case you're interested. Although it did cause me some consternation later on, it was a fair enough pattern, not exactly the most congruent thing in the world, but for my first attempt at making combinations, it was fair enough. So off I flew to the fabric store. It's like seamstresses of the past are encouraging me not to give up. Thank you. Thank you, Queen. So I think I got everything that I need. Maybe I found this material in the clearance section, because I don't pay full price for anything except tea. I decided to keep the color palette of my combinations and garter rather neutral. Fabric recommendations were things like cotton or satin. I decided to keep it simple and just go with cotton. This particular pattern includes lace insertions. I chose to use nylon instead of lace, mainly due to the fact that lace is hella expensive per yard. The material for the garter was somewhat different than the combinations. It needed to be a non-stretch material, as well as a little bit of an embellishment that I happened to find by complete and total accident in the clearance bin.
Step one for making the combinations would seem pretty straightforward. Measure out and cut 3 rectangles from the cotton. However, this was the beginning of my journey of issues with the no-cut pattern.
This pattern isn't making much sense to me. Let me start off with, apparently this set of combinations is supposed to be able to be made out of a yard. I did get a yard. The width of that yardage bolt, I guess you could say, needs to be 40 inches wide. This is 44 inches, and yet somehow it's not wide enough. The instructions aren't very clear. I haven't even started sewing yet. I've only been cutting out this pattern. I don't know if I'm getting a stress headache or a caffeine headache. One of those things can be addressed more quickly than the other. So, I think I'm going to make myself a cup of tea and take a break. I will check back in with you when I have figured it out.
I think I should briefly explain a little better what it was I was going on about. The illustration that comes with the pattern of how you're supposed to cut things out is deceptively simple. You see that it's 40 inches by a yard and also gives the measurements of the 3 rectangles that you're supposed to cut out. However, those are more like guidelines.
It is more what you'd call guidelines than actual rules.
And what I was discovering is that there was a discrepancy in seam allowance as well as movement allowance. I wouldn't really be able to step in to the combinations because my legs are 24 inches at the widest point. And even though I was going to be adding lace insertion at the sides, I would have to add quite a few inches in order to just make the garment wearable. I also discovered that the 2 inches that you needed to cut around in order to create the tabs that would go between the legs was not going to be enough inseam to be walking with. So I was frustrated and annoyed that I would need to add room into the combinations if I wanted to move. And I wasn't sure that I would be able to do that considering I had bought exactly what the instructions had told me to do, which was only 1 yard. Eventually, I was able to figure something out and began cutting and measuring in earnest.
Strike that. Reverse it.
Delicately, I began the cautious process of cutting out the nylon, then began compiling all the pieces with their retrospective parts to be sewn together.
I finished the top half. I needed to add an additional panel, which is going to be at the back, and haven't quite figured out how that's gonna work on the bottom half, but I'll figure that out. That's for future me, not present me. Had I not had to add this extra panel and possibly cause myself some problems down the road on the bottom half, I think I would have got it done today. So I'm gonna be doing some busy work with that. I will see you tomorrow.
After completely finishing the top half and having to make some little hand-sewn adjustments, I was ready to start on the bottom half and then connect the two together. And as anticipated, there was a discrepancy between the width of the top half and the bottom half. And the solution that I came up with was a little bit inventive, where basically I made a couple of narrow triangles at the hip to create a curve, and then I just narrowed that angle to the width of the top half. Just as a side note, sewing that nylon was way less difficult than I expected it to be. Then all of a sudden, it was 1 a.m., my combinations were done, and I was feeling pretty jazzy. I have no regrets. consider yourself blessed by my turn of the century version of risky business. Just take those old records off the shelf. The last piece of the puzzle to begin was the garter, and I cannot tell you how relieved I was to have a cutout pattern, mainly because I didn't have to do any guesswork as to the measurements. Though this did not eliminate me making mistakes, it did give me more confidence as to what I was doing. This garter was pretty clever at hiding its seams. How it worked was you would sew the raw edge to the inside, then you would go to the right side of the material, sew down the other side, creating the boning channel, which also encased the raw edges. Clever garter. I did run into a literal snag when closing off the boning channels, but this was soon overcome and I was on my way to adding the waistband, because I hate bias tape, and getting on to the fun part. Just as a side note, you as the viewer only have to experience this for a few seconds, but this delicate little process took 3 hours. But it was worth it.
Enjoyed another one of my sewing adventures. Let me know in the comments section if you would like to see me make a video on the 1920s dress that I plan on making for this upcoming spring. I know my sewing videos don't usually do as well as other videos on my channel, but I really can't be bothered to care. If you did enjoy this video, please leave a like and a comment for me, because it makes me feel like you're smiling at what I do. And to quote Nick,
one of those rare smiles, it seemed to understand you and believe in you just as you would like to be understood and believed in.
So until the next time, farewell!